to our latest segment called What's New at Spellbinders. My name is Nicole Westervelt, and I am excited to be revealing a brand new collection from licensed designer Becca Feakin, also known as Amazing Paper Grace. Now, this collection is called Candlewick Sampler. Let's take a look. The first die we're going to look at in this collection is called the Candlewick Colonnade Border. This is S3-382, and it is two dies. It's kind of your base die, and then it is a outside cut line. So you're going to get your base beautiful detail here, and then you're going to have your outside cut line that you can use if you wish to cut this out. Now, one thing to note is that this piece here is a score line. So if you want to cut it, you can just bring in your paper trimmer later and cut it. But you can also then use this score to create a beautiful topper such as this. So note that that score line happens right here. Now, if you would rather, you can die cut two of these pieces together and create a beautiful pendant such as this. And that's just by cutting out one and then running it through and cutting out the other side again with that outside cut line. So let's take a look at a finished project. Here you go. So one thing that you will want to take note of is on all of these projects is that there's this beautiful candle wick detail. And you're going to want to A, make sure that you emboss all of it, but B, you'll notice that these little candle wick details are just perfect for placement of pearls and gems and other things to adorn your projects. Next up, we have Candlewick Canopy. Now, this is S4-1016. There's two dies in this piece. And this is what they look like. So you have this beautiful canopy. Again, you see that candle wick element. And then you have this little motif that you can use to help adorn your projects. Now here's what they look like cut out. This is a broken record, but every single one of these dies has beautiful embossed details. So you're gonna wanna not only cut it out, but also make sure you run it back through a second time to get that beautiful detail. And here's the little piece that goes with it. And here's a finished project featuring this. Now in this example, ran it through two times and rotated it. So you see there's one here in the back in cream and then one over the top here cut out in a beautiful mirror gold. And then those two are just layered right on top of one another to create this gorgeous card. The next die in this Candlewick sampler collection is the Candlewick Petticoat. And this is S4-1018. And this is really the die, I think, that epitomizes the whole collection. And there's some fun elements that I want to point out. So in this collection, in this SKU, you get three dies. You're going to have your base piece here. You're going to have your outside cut line. And then you're going to have this additional little kind of what we're calling the petticoat one, which is this is a cut line. So your internal is cut, this external piece is cut, and then this here is actually a score line. And I'll show you why that is important. But the beauty of this, when you cut this out, so I cut this piece out here with the score, and then I cut it off here just to show you what this little piece can look like. But the beauty of the additional little petticoat, if you will, is you can cut that out and really layer these up to create this little kind of petticoat that peeks out. The other thing you can do though with this being a score is you can create a gorgeous gatefold card. So I took this with the 12 by 12 sheet of paper and just scored the paper at 3 inches and 3 inches on either side. And then because it is a score line here, you can create this gorgeous gatefold. Isn't that beautiful? Now let's see a finished card with these dies. Here we go. So again, you'll see where we brought in the base piece and then we repeated that down here. And then here's where you see the little kind of petticoat peeking out from below. Now we have the Grand Pocket out of the Candlewick Sampler Collection. This is S4-1022. Now Becca loves pockets and this truly is a grand pocket. This is a very, very good sized pocket. Now your die is going to come with actually four pieces because not only will you have the pocket, but you'll have some flowers that you can use. Again, cinch and go tie flowers you can use to decorate your projects. So let's take a look at this die. It is big. So here it is. We don't call it grand pocket for nothing, right? So here is this pocket. And again, you have the three little flower dies that come with it. And here's the little flowers cut out. Again, you're gonna wanna emboss those and then you can create a cinch and go flower with those by layering those up. But here's what the pocket looks like cut out. Now I wanna show you a little trick here on this because this side of the die right here is a score line and this is where you're gonna fold to kind of create the pocket. So this is cut out actually like this. You're going to want to cut it out, the piece of paper like this, and then you'll trim off the excess down here. And then you'll fold it up, wrap it around, and then you have a nice little pocket that you can use for gift cards, you can use for invitations, you could just use for a nice little sentiment, anything that you'd want. This would be lovely in scrapbooking as well. So that is kind of how the basic pocket works. But let me show you what Becca and her team did. They actually created a card using two pockets. So you see here that you can also use these pockets just simply to adorn the corners of your card. And look at how lovely, elegant that is. All right, our next die is the Kennewick Exquisite Topper. Now this one is incredibly versatile. This is S4-1023, and there are three dies in this SKU, and we call this kind of a split rim, and I'll show you why. So you have your base piece here. So this is your base piece, again, with that beautiful Kennewick detail, but then you also have an outside cut line for the top, and you have an outside cut line for the bottom. So if you want to make it just cut out the piece, and then you'll be left with something like this, which is stunning and gorgeous. Or if you want to make this kind of a topper, then you would remove this cut line here and just run it through, and then you're left with something like this. So again, can make a beautiful topper to your cardstock. Now let me show you a finished project here where they've used really a little bit of everything. And here you have it. So you can see there's a little bit of all of those elements used. There's the cutout piece like we showed. There's the, instead of a topper, it's kind of a bottomer, if you will. But then also just using this die here to create these outlines, which then act as almost little petticoats for the bottom of those. So just a stunning project created all with that single die. Very versatile, great value on this die. The next SKU in this collection is called the Kennewick Edged Corners, and this is S4-0124, and there are actually 9 dies in this SKU. It's really packed, and let me show you how that breaks down. So you have your two kind of primary pieces, which I kind of refer to as crowns, but they are intended to be used as crowns or corners or anything you'd like to do with them. So here's kind of your core pieces, but then just like we saw on the last SKU, they also have what we call the split rims. So then this piece, this kind of main piece here, doesn't actually cut, but then you can add the top and you can add the bottom and you can create little cutout designs. And you can do that for either of these two kind of crowns or corners, if you will. So see how that all comes together. Again, we call this our split rims, and they're so versatile because you can kind of mix and match to create different designs and looks. Now this one also has a few little value add flowers here. So there's a couple little flowers with some beautiful leaves. So here's what the cutout pieces look like. So you have your first kind of crown here. Let me slide all these down. So you have that one here. And then this is what the other one looks like. So there you go. And again, these are intended to be used as corners, but you can really use them to adorn a card in any which way. And then let me show you the flowers, because there's one thing I want to make sure that we point out about the flowers. And this is really the case for many Spellbinders dies, is that, again, I've been talking a lot about embossing. So if you can see, these are embossed. But don't forget, Spellbinders dies not only cut and emboss, sometimes they deboss, but you could also use them for stenciling. So for example, here we've just come back in and keeping the die in place. So you run the die through, you cut it out, you come back through, you emboss it, and then you can use this to stencil, just adding some ink, and then you have this cute little flower with this purple little petals. So isn't that fun? So let me show you a card that incorporates a lot of these pieces. Now I want to point out, so obviously we've used these as corners and interwoven kind of the little ends here to create four corners, but the centerpiece actually is this die, and you can see it's just trimmed off and created two of them to create a cute little pendant there to hold our sentiment. So just beautiful. The last SKU in this collection is an S5. It's S5402, and this is called our Kennewick Lace Card Front. Now, I'm going to tell you, the working name for this was Quick Card Front, and that is exactly what this is, because you can get a stunning result by just passing this die through your machine just a couple of times. And let me show you what the die looks like. So it's actually a set of two, so you have your outside cut line piece here, and then you have this beautiful intricate detail in the center piece. And by combining these two, you get this absolutely stunning result. So here's what it looks like, but if you back it here with like a piece of cream, you can really see that gorgeous detail. Now, in a separate video, we'll show you a trick on how to cut this out, because there is a trick to it to make it really fast and easy. But look at how beautiful that is. And then here's a finished project featuring that die set. So again, so simple, just run it through and then add a little sentiment and a little embellishment, and you have a beautiful card to pass on to your loved ones. So there you have it, the latest collection from Becca Feakin in What's New at Spellbinders. If you're looking for inspiration or insights, check out our blog. And remember, you can always shop anytime at spellbinderspaperarts.com.